School of Science and Technology is the fastest growing school at USIU Africa. The school offers globally competitive and innovative academic programs that incorporate research and co-curricular activities.
We have two master's programs, a Master of Science in Information System and Technology, and a Master of Science in Information System Security. The undergraduate program are a Bachelor of Science in Information System and Technology and a Bachelor of Science in Applied Computer Technology. We also have new upcoming programs, a Bachelor of Science in Software Engineering, a Bachelor of Science in Data Science and Analytics, a new PhD in Information Systems and Technology. We also have short courses and certifications in vendor-specific courses. This include IBM, Cisco, Microsoft, EC Council Certified Ethical Hacker, and Linux Professional Institute. These courses' duration is 1 to 3 months based on the specific short course. The school also has research programs. We have the Social Media Lab Africa, SimLab Africa. SimLab Africa is a social media analytics lab that focuses on social media consumption in Kenya. Over the last 2 years, SimLab Africa has been able to produce 2 reports on the status of social media consumption and use in Kenya. It has also been able to organize 2 symposiums, which are international conferences, are focusing on emerging trends in social media use and consumption globally.
The school is expanding its academic curricula. We are in the process of developing a BSc in Artificial Intelligence and Robotics and a PhD and MSc programs in Data Analytics.
We have several competitions that our students usually engage in. They're usually offered annually. For example, right now I can think of the Dell competition, which our students participated in recently. And there's also the Red Bull competition, which also took place this year. At present, we have our students applying for the Imagine Cup competition. Usually this competition gives students and faculty an opportunity to engage in interactive and innovative activities outside the classroom. When our students applied for the Dell competition, they had a very innovative project which looked at how we can be able to help mothers, especially in rural communities. So they came up with something that is portable, that is very economical, which can be used by mothers, or it can also be used by community health workers as they move around in rural areas. Some of the things the students have actually done is to create websites, which is part and parcel of what we teach them in school. This data is stored in databases and can be retrieved for later use. They use artificial intelligence for image recognition, and they are also able to build on their presentation skills. They can be able to pitch to investors and see if their innovations can actually help them get some money. Students are winning money from them. They are getting linkages with the industry. They are getting jobs out of it. So we feel it is something that is building onto what they are learning in class.
With the understanding that several small and medium enterprise companies have been forced to rethink their business model, especially during this pandemic, the School of Science and Technology launched a new initiative that tapped into an ecosystem of business resource organizations, teams and students, and together with faculty. The project was designed in such a way to help our students gain valuable work experience while giving the SMEs the much needed help they require in remaining afloat. So through this initiative, we are offering a no-cost digital service to SMEs in order to help them transition to a digital revenue and an operating model that is sustainable.
Currently, we have 2 projects that we are undertaking now. The first one is the AdaLab project. Here we have a company, AdaLabs, came in looking for two to three students from the APT program to participate in their first East Africa region competition of AI engineers. We are lucky to be the first university to participate in this program. Already 3 of our students have been selected. There's 1 faculty from the SST and a lab technician who will be working with these students to ensure that they are trained for the 4 months on deep learning, machine learning, and AI. Other lab intends to produce 300 engineers at the end of the program. Kakuma project is a CSR project with the School of Science and Technology, where we partnered with RET, an international NGO. We saw the need of training the youths in Kakuma refugee camp basic coding skills and basic computer skills. This is a project that has been so vital for us because it's giving back to society, to a group that is so vulnerable in the refugee camp with no tertiary education opportunities. And the program has been running for 1 year, and we closed it up this October, and 23 refugees graduated from that program.
The School of Science program are uniquely designed to involve hands-on skills development within highly technical software engineering, digital electronics labs within our campus. And we are able to give the right skills to our students because we have high qualified faculty members trained locally and internationally. Plus, the resources that we have, including our international partners. We have a mentorship program with Microsoft, where our students are assigned individual mentors by Microsoft. We're also able to access IBM resources online, and this improves our students' hands-on skill before they graduate. The School of Science and Technology at USIU has key research groups that the members are involved in research, and this research has been presented in international conferences, have been published in international journals, and we have faculty who have edited and authored books which are available in international markets. So every semester, the faculty members are expected to do journal publications. They're also expected to present conference papers, as well as to work with students throughout the semester to produce projects that can participate in international competition. The school have been able to achieve specific milestones, one of them being the number of students who are completing their master's degree in time. We are familiar that some universities usually have delay, but we've been able to improve our graduation rates, both for undergraduate and postgraduate. We have also been able to see our master's students participate in conferences and also do publications. And we have had our undergraduate students participate in international competitions.
To guarantee academic excellence, the school offers unique and top-notch laboratory facilities, electronic infrastructure, and human capital that to date remains unmatched in the region.